The wine is running out. One more time. The wine is running out.
The wine is running out.
Well, give yourself a hand for that. The incident in our text, this second chapter of John's Gospel, had to do with the first miracle of Jesus that we have recorded. After his baptism, and went out in the wilderness, and there being tempted of Satan, and he finally had to say to him, "Get behind me. I'm tired of you messing with me. Get hints. Get behind me." Jesus went about doing good. From that time, he went about performing miracles, going against the law of nature, bypassing, not going against it, bypassing the natural processes, the laws of nature, because he controlled nature. He made everything. You know, God is a healer. He heals through doctors too. Now don't go off on the deep end. Amen. I believe doctors are here for our purpose. They are ministers in the sense of the body. But we forget about God. Jesus himself is a doctor. Now he can heal you through your doctor. And when he does, you still ought to praise the Lord for it. Thank you, doctor. Thank you, doctor. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, doctor. Thank you, doctor. Praise you, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. But he can bypass all of those shots, all of those pills, all of that therapy, and can instantaneously heal you. That's what he did here in this second chapter of John. He performed a miracle. Well, now let us look at it then. It was a marriage.
Yeah.
And the institution of marriage was set up back in Genesis. It's right to get married. Person ought to look forward to getting married. It's sanctity. It's something sanctuary and sacred about it. The base of family life. I don't mean shacking together. The institution of the home and marriage was set up by God. Now Jesus didn't get married as such, but he sanctioned it by going to this marriage. And we ought to believe in marriage. It is honorable. It is honorable. And then ought to try to do all you can to make it work. Now I tell anybody rough. I don't know anything worthwhile not rough today. But that's the price you pay. If you're going to heaven, we keep on saying, you're not going there on flowery beds of Eden. No cross, no. to be some burdens. Got to be some problems. Jesus was invited to this marriage feast. This wedding. But not only was Jesus invited, there were others. This Jewish couple here must have been outstanding citizens in that community. Because the Bible said that the governor was there. They just took some time to name him. But if the governor came, they must have been somebody. Yeah, it had to be somebody. But whoever was doing the invite, so we better invite Jesus. Amen. We better not overlook him in making out the guest list now. We better, it's a fellow man by the name of Jesus. Amen. Of Nazareth. And we ought to invite him. Yes. Can I take my time? Yes. Which says something to us. You know, I don't care whoever else you invite, you ought to at least invite Jesus. Whether he come or not, extending the invitation. Extend to him an invitation. And I'm here to tell you, if you extend him an invitation, he'll come. There's one invitation that was extended with Mary and Martha, and he was a little late as far as they were concerned, a concern of their time. But he was on time. Amen. Because it was more glorious for him to raise Lazarus from the dead than it was for him to heal him.
All right.
He may not come when you want him. You invite him, though. Now one of the reasons why I invited me is that because you don't know when you're going to really need him.
Amen.
And it's better to have him on hand than have to send for him. Don't wait till you get in trouble. And do you not know that's when some of us pray? Some of us don't start begging the Lord until something happens. And all we cry, we moan, we groan. We come to church, start reading our Bibles, ask everybody we see, pray for me, pray for me. And baby, when you were flying high, you wouldn't come to church. Just too busy. Well, Reverend, I'll be there, but I'm in this committee, and I'm working with these people, and I'm working with them, and I'm just as soon as I can, I'm coming. But the moment the bottom falls out, you're the first one hit the door. Can I get a witness? We ought to, but this is a lesson. Are you gonna pray with me for a few minutes? That we ought to invite Jesus early. In other words, we ought to invite him in the beginning. Don't wait till you mess up. Don't you not know, I think we talked about the other night, that many of our marriages would have been more successful if we had invited the Lord when we were looking for a companion. In the beginning. I don't care whether it's in the beginning of a marriage, whether it's in the beginning of a day, don't wait till 12 o'clock. But early. When you get out of your bed, we ought to ask the Lord, Lord, you go with me today. Can I get a witness? I can't make it by myself. They got pitfalls, enemies out there. Hold my hand. Got my feet. Brown my my tongue. Protect me. Direct me. Can I get a witness? Baby, you ought to do that before you eat. We ought to get out of our bed, falling on our knees. Early in the morning. While the dew. You don't hear me. And just a little talk with Jesus in the morning there will help you to have a good day. That's what got our marriages, that's what got our home, that's what have our schools messed up. Now some of you are my age, everybody else is young. But I remember before we could start classes at school, you don't hear me. Reverend, I remember that. The principal of the school, we would have a general assembly, somebody would sing a song, would read the word of God, and somebody would pray. Israel, it's something about asking the Lord before you start out. Because if you don't, you might start out the wrong way. If you're going on a trip. Reverend, you know that what I like about you? That you haven't gotten too modernistic in the church. I hear the deacons out here singing and praying. Do you hear me? It's something to that. Before service starts, that's the beginning of service. Huh? I don't mean somebody call order now. Amen. Do you hear me? But I still believe in a prayer service. Do you believe in a devotional service? I believe somebody ought to stop and petition the throne of grace. For if all of this service is going to be for the edifying of the church and glorifying God, we need to ask the Lord to direct us. Direct the choir. Direct the preacher. Huh? Breathe on the members. Yes, sir. Look at what they did. They invited Jesus. Now, I'm sure there might have been somebody in the crowd said, oh, we don't need him. Because there's always somebody think you don't need him. But baby, whether you think you need him or not, you need him. All along this Christian journey, we need Jesus to walk with us. Shake somebody's hand and say, we need Jesus. I don't mean just need him when things are bad. But I mean when things are well, we still need Jesus. And then when a crisis comes, Christ is good for every crisis. Jesus is the answer. Can I get a witness? Nothing is too hard for him. I've seen him work in difficult situations. And you know, sometimes things can happen so fast, you ain't had time to think, time to pray, plan nothing. Just like Peter, when he starts sinking, he couldn't think about what he gonna say. Can I get a witness? When Peter found himself sinking, he just said, help, Lord. And sometimes that's all you need to do. We don't have to pray no long, drawn-out prayer. But if you mean it from your heart, the Lord will hear. The Lord will answer prayer. Look again, Jesus, Mary, some of the disciples were there. Mary noticed that the refreshments were gone. She went to Jesus. Said, Jesus,
that's all right.
The wine is out. Or almost out. Jesus said, no, my time is not yet.
That's all right.
Hallelujah. You can't rush him. I believe, and let me use my imagination, that when Mary told him that, because she was an observant woman, that there might have been just a little bit left. It was just getting low. And sometimes the Lord wants us to run all the way out. Can I get a witness? Sometimes he'll let you hit rock bottom. Can I get a witness? He'll let you get in such a predicament that when he brings you out, you can say like Pastor said a while ago, nobody but you, Lord. Because sometimes if you got a little bit left there, you take credit. But Jesus wanted to let them run all the way out. Huh? That they would give him the honor, the praise, and the glory. Well, when the wine ran out, and I want to tell you that your wine going to run out. Can I get a witness? No, I'm not talking about the ferment, but I'm talking about, for wine here represents the resources and materialistic things of this world. Can I get a witness? I don't care how much you got now. Ain't nothing in this world will last forever. Don't you get beside yourself. If you're young, you're on your way to getting old. Youth gonna run out on you. Beauty will fade. You don't hear me. The wine will diminish. You will diminish. We're getting older. If you don't believe you're getting older, you go look in the mirror. Huh? You ain't what you used to be. Fading. Steps getting short. Eyes are dim. Y'all thought I was born with these glasses? No. I need them. My wine is running out. Huh? Your mind one day won't always be alert. The wine is running out. And listen, I don't care how popular you are. You may be famous, but one day you'll be a has-been. And you need, can I get a witness? Somebody to lean on. You need somebody to hold your hand, to guide your feet, let your mind. Can I get a witness? You need it. Well, since it will run out on you, you better invite him. Because when all of these so-called friends, when they get through using you, and they go on the other way, you need somebody that will stick closer than your own sister or brother. Somebody that will be a father and a mother. Can I get a witness? I don't care what you got. And don't you get carried away because you got a little degree. You can wake up in the morning as crazy as a Betsy Boo. Can I get a witness? It's all right to have something, but don't get so wrapped and tied up in it. As soon as the Lord began to bless some of us, We forget all about God. Can I get a witness? What you ought to do is just take it and say, thank you, Lord. I know I didn't have it when I got here. And I'm going to leave it. Or it's going to leave me. And when I die, ain't no money truck gonna get in the funeral procession. And ain't no moving van going to the graveyard. I got to lead it to somebody. Can I get a witness? Thank you, Jesus. Only what we do for Christ will last. Shake somebody's hand and say, only what we do for Christ will last. Can I get a witness? I came to tell you that you accept Jesus and invite him in. When you get in a crisis, he'll be right there. Can I get a witness? Matter of fact, he won't come in. He said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man open the door, I'll come in and sup with him and he with me. How many of you know he'll do it? Yes, Lord. He said, if you do that, when you pass through the walls, I won't let him overwhelm. When you pass through the fire, I won't let it burn. If you're in the lion den, I won't let him bite you. Can I get a witness? Jesus. The water was the wine without. Jesus was on hand. And thank God, nobody had to remind him. Nobody had to tell him. For he knows when you're right. He knows when you're wrong. He knows when you're down. He knows what you're going through with. And the songwriter said, he knows how much you can bear. Can I go in? The Bible said that Jesus told his disciples and said he had six of them there. Can I get a witness? And there were six water pots. Can I take my time? Jesus told his disciples to build water pots. It was a water pot for each one. Fill them with water. In other words, Jesus was in the midst of an empty society. Just like he is here now. Jesus, that's what it means, is in the midst of an empty society. In the midst of a cold world. In the midst of a lifeless situation. Can I get a witness? For water pots are made of stone. Water pots, they were empty. Water pots, they were lifeless. I'm going to close it now. And you going to tell me? I want to tell you that this world is a cold world. This world is a mean world. This world is a low-down world. This world is a hard-hearted world.
this world is a lifeless world. Can I get a witness? Oh, Lord. I know folks think they're living when they got a few little things. But, oh, I feel better now. If you really want to live, you better come to Jesus. Can I get a witness? Jesus order them and commands us to fill the water pot. Fill him all the way to the brim. Can I get a witness? Oh, thank you, Jesus. Can I get a witness? Every one of us tonight, the Lord is talking to us. And he never tells you to do anything that you can't do. Can I get a witness? Oh, thank you, Jesus. If he tells you to get up from there, the Lord will. He'll give you strength. If he tells you to make one step, he'll be there to make the second one. Can I get a witness? If the Lord tells you to go, he'll sure go with you. Can I get a witness? Shine.
Stand on your feet, lift your hand and say, shout.
There's deliverance in it. There's power in it. There is love in it. I want the light from the light. Somebody will feel better. I don't know why, but I feel like I want to do it again. Somebody feels so down in the dumps, feels so all alone. You've been going through so much this week. Can I get a witness? Nobody really knows. Smiling, but you are smiling to keep from crying. Can I get a witness? Well, tell him to shine. Oh, yeah, shine. The lighthouse.